She means it'll be fun, I think.
Yeah, I brought this to take bird pictures for my class project. It's a new insult, instant camera. I'll show you how it works. Smile, Murphle. Hey! Murphle's invisible.
Nah, he's just shy. Bridge.
Now we can't get to the forest.
You don't miss much, do you, Rocco?
Oh.
Do not become distressed, people. I know of a sturdier structure downstream.
Now you tell us. Let's go. Okay, grab a tail, gang. Chatter, you lead. Pinky and I will cover the rear. Pinky? Oh, terrific. I spent half my day looking for that kid.
Oh, brother. Another curious episode in the saga of the vanishing infant. Where will it all end?
Okay, guys. Hold the hike. It's look for Pinky time again.
We can't let him wander the forest alone. Yeah, it's a jingle out there.
Everybody, spread out to cover the area. You can't be far.
Here's a megaphone you can use to yell with.
Pinky! Pinky!
Pinky! Pinky! Chatter, do you have to yell that loud? Of course. We must employ high decibel levels to penetrate the dense foliage.
I think you just penetrated my eardrums.
It's time we got organized. Organization. We'll split into search parties of two. Then maybe we'll stay out of each other's way long enough to find Pinky, wherever he is. like the right direction to me. To keep looking for Pinky. You'd better go find my dad to help us.
You can call on me, Pinky. Boss Brick. Okay. I'll probably get a gold medal, a moldy kettle, a gold medal for rescuing Pinky. Oh, and may even get a medal for saving. Hey, how about Wildfire? Come back here! Kiddo, I'll get your puppy back, I promise. First, we put up reward signs all over the neighborhood. Now,
tomorrow we'll get the Rainbow Panthers to help us look for wildfire. Better cover your ears, Panky. Glad you could make it, Rainbow Panthers. We need your help. Later, Panky. I'm telling the Panthers what happened. You see, Panky's new pup ran away, and we've got to find him.
Look!
That's him, Panky. Wildfire, come back!
The mud, huh? Then let's move out and cash in.
Relax, kiddo. He's just on the other side of that bulldog!
That big bulldog is bad news.
I wouldn't want to go 15 rounds with him.
Appearances can be deceiving. I'm confident I can work my wiles upon his gentler sensibilities and persuade him to surrender said infant canine to me.
Say what?
She means she's gonna sweet-talk the bulldog into giving her the pup.
Kitsy, kitsy, coo. Nice big doggy wuppy. Let Chatter have little puppy wuppy. Appears that immediate assistance is necessitated here. In other words, help!
So much for the direct approach. Let's huddle on plan B.
Now's our chance to tell Finko about all this.
Hey, Finko! We got some hot news!
Tell me from there! Stay back!
Don't you guys ever use brakes?
Panky lost his new puppy, and the Panthers will pay a big reward to get him back.
Reward?
As in money?
Now you're talking my language, Owl.
There's just one problem. A Super Jaws bulldog is guarding the puppy.
That's no problem. Let Pinky and the Panthers take care of the bulldog. We'll get the pup, and Pinky will have to come across with some handsome...
ransom.
Brilliant!
How come I didn't think of that?
Because I got the brains, and you're a total airhead.
Your computer-controlled cat works perfectly, Annie.
Nothing to it. Just a simple combination of some microchips and an old video joystick.
That oughta put the bulldog down for the count.
Okay, here's the plan. Annie runs her comfy cat past the bulldog. Then when he chases it, I go in to get Wildfire.
Unless I get him first.
Okay, comfy cat. Do your stuff.
Don't cry, kiddo. Now we'll get your doggy back.
Oh, boy, it's working like an arm. A farm. No, it's working like a charm.
Right, Pumpkin. And it's now or never.
Make that never, Pinky.
Howl, give me that pup.
I got him, and now I'm going to get my reward. Uh-oh. Sure KO'd Howl.
Yeah, and ruined my chance to get Wildfire.
Wildfire!
Don't cry, kiddo. I'll think of something.
Oh, maybe Annie should build another pussycat. A copycat. Oh, no, CompuCat.
No way, Pumpkin. I'm fresh out of parts.
I got it. Listen, Panthers.
You got scared off by a doggy?
What are you, Howl? A lion or a mouse?
Give me a minute on that one.
Forget it. Now take this steak.
Ooh, thanks.
It's not for you, lowlife. It's to lure the puppy into this.
Oh, I get it.
Just get the puppy.
Right.
Your proposed masquerade as a canine is a dubious proposition at best, Pinky.
Meaning?
Meaning I don't think you'll fool that bulldog with that silly dog suit.
Chata. At least I'll get close enough to grab Wildfire.
Woof, woof. Woof, woof, woof.
Pinky, we're not ripped yet.
Work, Finko!
Yeah! Sometimes my brilliance amazes even me.
Now, let's return him to the Panthers and collect the cash.
Return him? I can get twice as much as they can pay. Come on!
Oh, Daddy, isn't he cute? Can I have him?
Oh, he's a real steal, mister. Only $100.
We'll take him.
And now to enjoy the fruits of my finkery.
What about my share, Finko?
Oh, of course. Here's $1.
All right, Finko. Hand over Pinky's puppy.
Oh, Wells.
Sorry, Pinky. You're too late. I just sold him to a higher bidder.
I see him, Pinky. Hang on. Hey, wait, mister! We'll take a shortcut. Over this fence. Or under it. Hold it, mister! That's our dog! It really is his dog.
And I'm afraid I don't understand.
It's a wonk stool.
You better let me tell it, Pinky.
Damn darn video button. It ain't every cent I got for that pup.
Not every cent, Pinko. I still got my dollar.
You mean my dollar?
That's my dollar. And you owe me 99 more for selling me a dog that wasn't yours.
It sure was nice of that man to let us mow his lawn to work off the money.
Nice! He's got 5 acres of jungle here.
Well, Pinky, it looks like Finko and Hal are gonna have a lawn, lawn day. Get it, Pinky? Lawn?
We now return to the Pink Panther and Son.
Straighten the house, Panthers. My cousin Punky should be arriving any minute. He's staying with Panky and me for a few days.
Oh, boy. You didn't want to join the rope.
Murphle says we should take the kid in that corner and show him the ropes.
Well, that's why he's coming, guys. His folks wrote Dad a letter saying poor Punky had no pals to play with.
Great. We'll have a blast. Whoops.
Your cousin Punky has chosen a fortuitous time for his visit as it coincides with the film festival honoring your father.
Yeah, it'll be a real family affair tonight. In fact, Dad's in the garage right now looking for his best shorts.
Hey, you can borrow a pair of mine, Pinky.
Film shorts, Rocco. Film shorts.
Faster, man, faster. I must get my latest discovery to the museum before it thaws.
Hey, what's back there, Dr. Van Loon?
What's back there? Only the missing link between today's domestic cats and the ferocious felines of yesterday. Now step on it.
Shut the door behind you. And this is Annie O'Gizmo.
Doesn't say much, does he?
I guess he's just a low-key kind of cat. Cousin Punky, Dad. He seems a little high-strung, so we're gonna take him out for a little while, okay?
Maybe Punky would like to try his hand at the video arcade.
Yeah. What do you say, cousin?
Hey, Pinky, who's your far-out friend?
Yeah, Finko. Get a load of that furry pink weirdo.
Don't bother me, Howl. I'm 200 points away from a free game.
This is my distant cousin Punky, Leona.
Charmed, I'm sure. I just love the strong, silent type.
I did it! It took 3 years, but I won!
No, not again! Quick, Leona, grab him!
My pleasure, Pinky.
Hey, no fair! I had a free game coming!
Who's gonna pay for this?
Gee, thanks for helping us out, Dad.
And you, stay out of here.
Hey, how about reimbursement for the free game I missed?
Get lost, Finko. Nothing's for free.
Ice cream, ice cream!
Good idea, Pinky. Maybe an ice cream will cool off our cousin.
Hey, kids, get some nice cold, ice cold ice cream.
Get what I said about good idea, Pinky.
That's 2 dozen vanilla cones, 14 ice cream pies, 8 frozen chocolate bars, and 1 set of bells. Now, who's gonna pay for all this?
Oh, sorry we have to bother you again, Mr. Pater. A panther.
Thanks, Dad. Listen, Punky, you're just gonna have to learn to control yourself. You said it, Murphle. Cousin Punky is an expensive guest to have around.
I've seen boxers act the same way. Real calm, then they go wild in the ring.
Ring? You've hit it, Rocco.
I did?
Yes. The doorbell, the video game, the ice cream truck all had ringing bells.
Annie appears to have isolated the troublesome stimulus, Pinky.
Just in time, too. We're all due at my dad's film festival in a couple of hours.
If you ask me, taking this guy along is a risky perspiration. Preparation. No, I mean proposition.
Yeah, Punky might KO the place. One bell and he comes out swinging.
Then we gotta make sure he doesn't hear one. and I think I know how.
Quite a crowd has gathered at the hotel for tonight's festival banquet honoring the films of the Pink Panther. He's just arrived with his two sons, their friends, and a sordid relative.
Those earmuffs were a good idea, Pinky, but I didn't have much time to soundproof them.
Then we better keep an ear out. No, I mean an eye out for any bells.
Our guest of honor will screen some of his favorite films for us. Right after the gourmet meal prepared by our French chef. Ladies and gentlemen, dinner is served.
Quick hands, Rocco.
First time I ever jumped a bell.
If we get through this banquet, I shall take it upon myself to teach you the rudiments of etiquette, Punky.
And now for our first short, Pink Pandemonium.
The Panther Rouge is mon favorite. I keep one eye on the souffles, the other on the film.
Punky's behaving himself so far.
I am receiving olfactory evidence of an apparent conflagration.
I smell something burning.
Sacre bleu! The souffles, they're flambé.
Oh no! Fire!
Oh no! Fire bells! Sorry we let Cousin Punky get out of hand and mess up your night, Dad.
Au contraire! He has saved the day by putting out the fire! Bravo, mon ami! You are the hero! Yeah.
Yeah. We've taken all the necessary precautions, Pinky. The phones are off the hook.
You said it, Murphle. No way those alarm clocks are gonna ring. In fact, when it comes to bells, I think we've got everything covered.
I regret to inform you that in your haste, you apparently have overlooked the front doorbell.
Whew, that was close.
Afternoon, kids. I'm Dr. Darwin Van Loon, and I've been searching the neighborhood for a missing link. He looks something like that.
You mean that's not Cousin Punky?
Certainly not. That's my missing link. Thanks for looking after him. Hope he didn't cause much trouble. These links can be real terrors if they hear any ringing.
Ha, we know. We know.
Hold it, kiddo.
Why, you must be Cousin Pinky. I'm your Cousin Punky. Sorry I'm a day late.
That's okay, cousin. At least we won't have to worry about bells with you.
Bells? Horns drive me batty!
We now return to the Pink Panther and Son.
Here you are, Panky. Just like I promised. A special bedtime snack. Crackers and peanut butter.
Ugh, I want candy.
Remember what I told you about a balanced diet.
Can't sleep.
You can't sleep? All right, I'll read you a bedtime story. Once upon a time, long, long ago, in a far-off land of genies and flying carpets, two young panthers were lost in the desert. Desert map. Panky, This is a dessert menu, not a desert map. Don't you ever think of anything but sweets?
Uh-uh.
Come on, we better find something to drink fast, or we'll never make it to Bad Gag.
Look!
Sorry, Pinky. It was just a mirage. Uh-oh. We'd better keep moving before we end up on a menu.
Come one, come all to the Bad Gag Candy Bazaar.
Our exotic candy concession appears to be thriving nicely.
Especially with El Rocco in your corner to KO any thieves.
Yeah, we all feel safe with you around, Rocco. It would appear we have been the victims of a vandalization.
Not only that, but we was robbed.
Ha-ha! Consider yourself honored to be robbed by Howly Baba and his 40 seeds.
Howly Baba? We're lucky we still have a roof over our heads.
Looks like this is the end of the line, kiddo.
Look!
Oh, forget it, Pinky. It's just another mirage.
It's Wawa, a lot of lemonade.
Pinky, it's real water. We're safe.
Yay, we're home!
Yeah. Uh-oh, sounds like we got company. Oh, no! It's Howly Baba and his bandits. Quick, Pinky, hide!
What I tell you, man, easy as taking candy from a baby. Yuck, yuck, yuck.
Yuck, yuck, yuck.
Now to hide the goodies with the rest of the stash. Open sesame.
Candy everywhere.
Whoops, almost forgot. Close sesame!
Ooh, that was close, kiddo. Let's hang around and see what they're up to.
Live it up, guys!
Watch this, guys. Do you know what the bandits would do to us if they found us?
Open sesame! Why, they probably didn't. Yikes!
Who left that door open?
Hi, quick!
Thieves! There they go!
Get them! Just can't figure them.